Sony Computer Entertainment America presents a Universal Interactive Studios production.
A game created and developed by Naughty Dog.
Press start to begin.
Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to my new Let's Play, a Let's Play of Crash Bandicoot Warped on the PlayStation 1. This game was originally released in 1998 and was developed by Naughty Dog. And right now, we are going to select a new game, and we're going to jump right in. But first, we've got a cutscene.
Free at last.
Uka Uka is free. No, it cannot be.
Evil, great evil has come.
Uka, it was that infernal Bandicoot.
From deep inside my temple prison, I sent you simple instructions to follow. But you lost the gems. You lost the crystals. And I have lost my patience. There is now no other power source left on this planet.
I know. We've had a few unfortunate setbacks.
And failed. But since your bumbling has managed to set me free, I am feeling generous. There is still a way for us to amass the power needed to enslave this miserable planet. And this time the great Uka Uka will make sure that you do it right.
After many eons, my evil twin Uka Uka has been freed from his underground prison. Long ago, I locked him there to protect the world from his malice. Now, free once again, he must be stopped. Children, Uka Uka and Cortex plan to use this time-twisting machine to gather crystals that lay scattered across time. I have brought you here to recover the crystals before they do so. To open the time portal, simply stand on a button and then jump into the portal. Good luck.
Alright, here we go. Let's get to it. So welcome to Crash Bandicoot Warped, ladies and gentlemen. Those of you that have followed my channel since at least 2010 may be familiar with this game. Because believe it or not, this is actually not new territory for me. This is actually a game that I did back in 2010. And it was my first Let's Play using a capture card and a microphone to actually record footage instead of just using a camera mounted in front of a TV screen. And while I was happy with the project at the time, looking back, it was a pretty rough one. It was a pretty rough product overall because I was still learning the ropes back then. And, you know, for the past couple years, I have been wanting to revisit this game. And I figured that since I've just come back from a little hiatus and, you know, I'm kicking off a new year, I decided what better way to kick off 2014 than to revisit an old favorite. And this really is an old favorite for me because this game features some of my earliest memories of the PlayStation 1. So, To get to what is on the screen right now, welcome to the Time Twister Machine. This is basically the hub world of the game, and it is divided into five sub-areas. Each sub-area contains five levels for a total of 25 main levels in the game, and we're going to have to go through all of them to complete the game. And we're going to start off with this first area, the only available area to us. And we've got the first five levels of the game: Toad Village, Under Pressure, Orient Express, Boneyard, and Making Waves. And obviously we're going to start off with level one. So we are starting off with Toad Village, so let's get to it. First level of the game.
Crash, crash, crash. Why must you always muck in my mud? Oh, look, I have a mask helping me, too. We will find out which one is more powerful soon enough.
Alright, so let's get to it. That was Dr. Neo Cortex, who just spoke with us. He is the main villain of this game, and he is pretty much the primary villain of the entire Crash Bandicoot series as a whole. Now on to the gameplay. So this is the first level of the game, Toad Village, and like most platformer games of this type, the objective of Crash Bandicoot games, the objective is pretty simple. You just start at the end of one level and you have to get to the other end without dying. And you also have to break boxes and collect objects along the way. So there are three objects in the game that we're going to have to collect. Crystals, gems, and relics, which we'll get into later. Go to this pad right here that has a question mark on it, and you will be taken to a bonus area. A special little side area of the level that, even though it's a bonus level, it is actually required to get full completion of the stage. This one isn't too bad, it just introduces the concept of bonus stages, but some of them are going to be a little trickier as we go through the game. So the controls of Crash Bandicoot are pretty simple to learn and understand. You move Crash Bandicoot around by using either the D-pad or the left analog stick. X button makes you jump. A circle button lets you do either a belly flop in mid-jump, or it lets you slide while running. You can also crawl by holding circle button and moving. A square button allows you to do a spin attack, which is Crash's basic offensive move, which he has always had since the very first Crash Bandicoot. And that's pretty much the controls in a nutshell. Very simple to learn and understand. This object I just collected is a crystal. There are 25 crystals in the game. We have to collect all 25 in order to get full completion of the game. The other collectible item that we can get through the stages is this thing, a gem. You activate, you get a gem for destroying all the crates in a given level. Toad Village has 42 crates, we have destroyed all 42 crates, which means we get the gem! And when you reach the end of the level, you activate a portal that takes you back to the Time Twister. And that's Stage 1 Toad Village, ladies and gentlemen. So we've got one crystal and one gem, but trust me, folks, they're not all going to come so easily in this game. And Crash does a little victory dance, but we ain't done yet. There is a third collectible that we can get in each level called a relic, and we're about to see what those are all about. So let's see what's up.
Crash, Coco, if you have already retrieved a level's crystal, then you will find a floating clock when you enter for the second time. This floating clock activates time trial mode. Grab it, and the clock will start ticking. race for the end to get the best time. But beware, some elements will change.
Thanks for the heads up, Aku Aku. Sounds interesting. So you can, after you've gotten a crystal or a gem or whatever, you can revisit any level anytime that you want. And as Aku Aku just explained, we now have a floating clock. So let's touch it! And now we are in time trial mode, and as Aku Aku said, some elements will change. The first major difference, there are no Wumpa Fruit. Wumpa Fruit are those weird little apple-like things. They are basically like coins in Mario or rings in Sonic. You collect up to 100 of them and you get an extra life. And another key difference is that you have these special yellow crates. Break a yellow crate and depending on the number, either number 1, 2, or 3, you will stop the clock for a certain amount of time. And stopping the clock is very important in order to be able to get the best time and hopefully get a relic. So, time trial, it's simple. Activate that clock and haul ass to the end of the level. And you're really gonna need to haul ass in order to get some of the best times in this game. I kid you not. And we're about to get our first relic right now. 5936. Not too bad to get a sapphire relic. And let's enter our initials. So that's the first time trial of the game. Every stage has a time trial mode, and you can actually get different color relics. There are three different color relics in the game. Sapphire, which are the easiest to get, gold relics, which are a little bit harder, and special platinum relics, which, depending on what level, can be damn near impossible to get. I am going to be going for, at best, gold relics. If you're expecting an all-platinum relic run of this game out of me, you're going to be disappointed. I'm just not that good. But I will do my best to get at least gold relics. And I know in my original LP, I actually did not show off the time trials. I only showed off Toad Village just to demonstrate the concept. But in this LP, I actually will be showing off the time trials. But I'll be dedicating the time trials to their own special little videos. And I actually won't get to the time trials until much later on. So I could go on to the next level, but we still have a few other things here in the Time Twister to show off. First of all, we've got this big-ass screen right here, dead center. So we're gonna check this out. This is the load save screen where, well, you can either save your game or you can load a game. You can also delete a game. You can save up to 4 files. Right here, this is my practice file, which I've got 100% completion for. And when it comes to completion, like relics, gems, and crystals, all of them are vital for full completion of the game. Which is kind of obvious, of course. So let's enter a name for this file. And, file is saved. So there we go. We've got one crystal, one gem, one relic, ones across the board for 3% completion. Now we're going to take a quick look at the pause menu. The pause menu is pretty basic. It's just resume, options, and quit. Options are basically just sound options, controller vibration, and centering the screen. Let's not mess with any of that. You can also press a triangle button to look at different status screens. You can see how many crystals you have, how many powers you have, we'll get into those later on, how many gems you have, and how many relics you have. So we've got one of each collectible in this game for 3% completion, and I'd say that this is a pretty good place to stop. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for this first episode of this Let's Play of Crash Bandicoot Warped. We have covered most of the basics of this game. We've started the game for real with the first level, Toad Village, and managed to get everything for the time being. So that's going to wrap up this episode. So hope you folks watching this liked what you saw. And if you did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it, like I always do. I'm glad to be back into LP, and it's good to be back into the swing of things. And I hope to make a good LP of this game, much like I tried to do with my first LP. So if you like what you see in this video, be sure to stick with me, and we'll see where we go from here with this game. So this is Ultimate Life from RV signing out for now, and I'll see all of you in the next episode.